Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In this video, we'll learn all about the magic wand tool. So let's see how it all works. Here I've got some of these patterns. It's just for an example. You can always access these patterns under your swatch panel or otherwise here, and you'll have patterns somewhere there. There you go. You can have there, there's a lot of patterns you can choose from. It's just to help us. The magic wand tool is the third selection tool here. What it essentially does is it selects anything which is very similar in the color, the weight, the stroke, or any other criteria. It just makes it so much easier to choose and select the same kind of object right across the whole of the Illustrator program. In Photoshop, it's slightly more needed, I think, because there you're actually selecting pixels, not clear objects. But even in Illustrator, we can see there are plenty of examples when you would use it. Like in this example over here. So say I've got this pattern, I'm just zooming in, holding Alt or Option and scrolling my mouse. You see these yellow squares part of this pattern. I expanded it all under Object Expand, so it's now each one is a separate shape. So if let's say I want to change the color of all these yellow ones, change them to some other color, the way we would do it is going to the selection tool, the direct selection tool, and choosing one, holding down Shift, choosing the next one and the next one and the next one, and by the end of the day maybe I'll manage to select the whole pattern. So thankfully we've got this tool, magic wand tool, and with one click I can select all the yellow squares within this whole pattern. Now I can easily go to the swatch panel and choose any color I want, and presto, the whole thing changes at once. That makes life very, very simple and easy. So I can choose anything I want and it will choose the same color. So if I select on this, this is a pinkish reddish color, or select anything else which is that same color. As you can see, it selects from here as well and from this pattern also. If you don't want it to select any of the other objects, you can always go under your layers panel and choose to lock some of those layers you don't want it to select from. Now we've got some settings for this magic wand tool. If you double click there, or under Windows and magic wand, you would get this box. To expand it, to see all the options, you can always press on this little icon next to the name. It's like that in all the Adobe windows. You can just take this out, for example. See the stroke panel over here, it only has one option here. If you press this, you would minimize that, and you press again, you'll have all the options there. Or you can always go under there and hide stroke options and hide transparency options. That would just hide or allow you to view them. So as you can see, I've got this fill color checked. What it does is allows this magic wand tool to select anything of that color, and it will select anything with the same matching color, as you saw I've demonstrated before with any of this yellow squares. So it selects one yellow square and all of the rest of the yellow squares will be selected. This tolerance, how similar does that fill color have to be in order for it to be considered the same color? You can go anywhere from 0 to 255. If it's in CMYK, then you would have only to 100, I think. What it means is you take any number, say I've got a 32, I think that's the default number. You divide that into 2 and you get 16, which means it'll be 16 steps, sort of, to the right side, or 16 steps to the left side in the similarity of its color. Then you've got stroke color, so you can choose to uncheck that and check only the stroke color, or you can check both and you'll get the matching ones based on the stroke color, not the shape but rather the stroke. As you can see, there's no stroke here. Say I've got this stroke like that. So anything with the same stroke color will be selected. Even if you got a yellow shape, it wouldn't be selected if you uncheck that fill color. because it's not the stroke color, so it has to be a matching stroke color. Let's demonstrate that. So I'm duplicating the square here and changing the thickness of the stroke. So you can see it's like 0.75, you wouldn't be able to see it even, and duplicating once again there and changing this color to blue. Once I use this, remember I have only the stroke color checked, so it will select objects only based on the stroke color. Say I'm going for this one, you'll see this and this get selected, but this one doesn't because this has a different stroke color, even though the stroke size of this is different. Let's just go back to there with double clicking. Then you've got stroke weight, that's based on the thickness, so it has to match the thickness. So if I choose that now and I will select on that square, then these two will be selected, even though it's different colors, but the same stroke width. And once again over here, you've also got tolerance. You can either enlarge it from there or just putting in the number you want and pressing enter, or you can use the keyboard arrows and bring up the number or down. So you can choose once again to choose based on all of those, or otherwise you can leave only according to stroke weight. Then opacity is based on the opacity of the object. If you got 100% opacity, then I think all the objects will be selected, but you can choose the same object to be chosen once you press on one of them. And blending mode, we'll learn about blending modes some other time. So once you've chosen the correct one you wish to do, then you'll be able to easily choose any one of the objects. That makes life very easy, selecting any object you want very easily. There is also another option under select, same as the one you selected, so I guess you have to select one and then select same appearance or same blending mode, or you can choose any one of these. You also got under object, you have so many others. And the difference between this and the magic wand is just that the magic wand, you have a tolerance that you're able to change. That's very helpful sometimes. But otherwise, in this panel, you've got so many more options. And notice, say I'm selecting the appearance or the fill color, so all the ones with the same fill color will be selected. And you can see it also selected these triangles. And see if I move it, then all those get selected. To add on the selection, you can just go back there and select same and choose any other element you want by these options here. They'll just add on the existing selection. Just under same link block series, that's quite a cool option. If you've got text and it's linked with another box, can see I'm linking this text with another box. There you go. So if you have many text boxes and you don't know which one is linked with what, and you may have a magazine or whatever the case may be, you can always go to select and choose same link block series. That will choose all the text box that are linked with that one, that the text flows into that box or from that box. So you can see it's selected there both. One last tip I want to show you, let's just erase these. If you've got many cases, you have this one straight point, you can't even see them. Look, if I click away, you can't see it. To select any straight points, you can go to select object straight points, and that will select those straight points even though you can't see them. And you can always delete them or do whatever you want with it. There is also another way to do that, that's with object path and clean up. That cleans up, you can see straight points, and any straight points have been removed from there. Now you can see there isn't any more straight points. Many times you just have them by mistake or however they go. Okay guys, thank you so much for joining me on this video. If you gained anything, please give a like and subscribe. Also, if you have any ideas or questions, please share it in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.